Women, we have a lot of trust issues, don't we? I'll tell you one reason why I have trust issues. Oatmeal raisin cookies. They look like chocolate chip cookies, but oh no, those little baked goods are deceiving. This Move Her series about trust issues is all about how we can still trust God, even when His answers aren't what we want, His timing isn't what we want, and we can't see the good in the situation. Now, the video last week talked about why do we have trouble trusting God, and there can be a lot of whys. The video today is going to dive into how we can become women who still trust God. Now, there are a lot of amazing stories in the Bible about trusting God, but one of my absolute favorites is the story of Ruth. So to tell you a little bit about Ruth, when we first meet her, Ruth, her mother-in-law, Naomi, and her sister-in-law had all recently become widows. There was a massive famine that went through the land, and over the course of multiple years, all of their husbands passed away. So Ruth finds herself, she lost the love of her life, she's a widow, there's a massive famine, they're in insane poverty, she has no protection, no provider, her husband passed away before they were able to have children, so she has no legacy. I mean, a lot of times people say bad things happen in threes, but for Ruth, this was like a baker's dozen of bad things. Now, Ruth had a choice to make, just like how we have a choice to make when we go through dark and tough times. She had two options. Option number one, she could go back to her own homeland and worship her own gods and basically say, you know what, God? You took everything away from me. So I'm turning my back to you and I'm gonna do my own thing. Or the second option, which was to follow Naomi back to Bethlehem and make the Almighty God her God. Well, Ruth chose the second option. So she goes back to Bethlehem with Naomi, and they are so poor that just to eat, Ruth had to go into random fields and pick up wheat that was lying on the ground. So they at least had something. Now, Ruth ends up finding herself in the field of a man named Boaz. Now, Boaz was a very well-known, very respected man who owned a lot of land, and he ended up taking notice to Ruth. And what happened is he started finding out some of her story about how even though when everything was taken away from Ruth, she still made the decision to trust God and to have faith in God. In fact, there's this awesome verse in Ruth, Ruth 2, verse 12. And this is Boaz speaking to Ruth. He says, "May the Lord repay you for what you have done. May you be richly rewarded by the Lord, the God of Israel, under whose wings you have come to take refuge." Well, Boaz becomes so interested in Ruth that they end up getting married. So Ruth, through making that choice to trust God, was totally redeemed. She found love again. She had protection again. She had a provider again. The famine had gone away. And you know how I mentioned earlier that her and her future or her previous husband were not able to have children before he passed away? Well, through the marriage of Boaz and Ruth, they became the great grandparents of King David, which is the genealogy of Jesus Christ. Talk about a legacy, right? Talk about a legacy for making a decision. There's this awesome verse in Job, Job 2:25, and this is God speaking. And he says, "I will repay you for the years the locusts have eaten." Now in that time, there was, again, another famine. Lots of famines going on in the Bible, apparently. But there was a massive famine, and God made a promise to the people that all the years that they had a famine and they had things stripped away, He was going to repay them for those hard years. And you know what? God still makes that promise to you. So when you go through super dark, challenging times, you can be sure that God can and will still redeem you. God can and will still repay you. And even if you feel like you're not repaid here on earth for everything that was stolen from you, you will be repaid. Because you know what? By making the decision to trust and love God even through hard times, you will be rewarded by being able to spend eternity with God in heaven. What a reward. So ladies, your challenge this week is to write down that verse in Job 2:25. I will repay you for the years the locusts have eaten, because God can be very surprising in the ways that he chooses to redeem you.